Hey guys, Dan Percival here, founder of the sport of extreme ice skating, and what you are looking at is an actual leather cutout of the extreme ice skate. So what this leather piece is the actual layout of the skate before it gets sewn onto the boot. So if you look closely here, you'll see that see how there's extra room here in the front? Well, this is the part that actually gets tucked around to the front of the skate. And then this gets sewn. And these are the actual holes where the eyelets would be. And here, this is the top of the skate. And then the middle of the back of the skate gets sewn to this piece. And vice versa on the other side. And this would get tucked under the last. From about here to the bottom of the boot, just a little bit here gets tucked under. The last would be the sole that gets affixed to the bottom of the sole. So what I'm doing now is I'm trying to get the layout perfect for the X design because we weren't getting it spot on every time or correct every time. So to fix for that problem, the manufacturer sent me the leather piece of the boot before it got actually turned into a boot, and it would be easy. So I thought it would be easier to just lay out the X on the boot, and in the fashion which I regard as an acceptable design. And then from that point on, they can take this exact design, and then this would be a leather piece. And then this would fit around, this would just bend and flex around the boot. So this is a piece of paper, but this would be cut out in leather. I do actually have another leather piece that they sent me, but it doesn't make sense to show you because you got the basic idea. It's just that this would be leather, and then the sewing of the red would go around the edges. All right, so they need metrics. They need to know exactly how to lay this X out. So what my job was to first go in Photoshop and create the X, which I did a long time ago, over a year and a half ago. But I had to go back and do it again. And then once I got it exactly how I liked it, laid out on this piece of leather here, then I took this, which is a sheet of paper printed out with the boot, which is exactly the same. Well, almost the same. The back is a little short by, I don't know, by maybe a quarter of an inch. But what this is basically the same in height and width. Like I said, it might be off just slightly. So the metrics are here. So what I determined was that, well, the point of the X design goes to the corner every time, as well to the corner here. And this is going to be a little tricky because this part gets actually tucked under, so this angle is actually going to wind up having to change, and we're going to have to fiddle with this back and forth. They're going to have to send me mail back and forth to and from the manufacturer to me, and they're going to have to keep sending me these leather pieces until we get it exactly correct. So this is going to be a problem here because we don't know exactly where that point is going to be. We just know that when it's done, that if assuming that this is the sole underneath, which it wouldn't be, this would actually be the sole here, that this the corner here would be exactly where it ought to be. And then you've got all kinds of other metrics, such as that the angle from here to here should fit the angle of this line. And then you've got, like for instance, this particular angle here is 10 millimeters, and this angle here is between 13 and 15. This angle here, when it actually bends, when you actually start bending it to sew onto the boot, it's going to change the actual contour and look of this so that it's going to make it look more straight. And I want it to look just slightly curved. So in that regard, we're going to have to, perhaps, that's why it says here, might have to be curved slightly higher. This might have to come up higher and to accommodate for this. At this point here, if you look straightly up, it comes over the seventh eyelet. This line, as it projects out, it comes between the fifth and the sixth eyelet, and so on and so forth. You, for instance, like the middle of here, the center of this X comes up slightly off from the center. And so this would be the metrics and the annotations. I have all kinds of standards and templates and rules here on how to start, but how to lay out the X so that it doesn't, it's not different every time. You start by matching this angle, then you match this angle in proportion with this angle over here, and then finally the last here. So that's basically it, and we're, for the next, I guess, few months, we're going to be working on getting the X design right, and hopefully the fifth prototype will be coming up to get the stiffening of the boot right. And I don't know exactly when that will be, but I will definitely do another video soon and let you guys know. Bye.